Sanjay Kumar has this question for us. He says he's 33 years old and his monthly income, which is combined with his wife, is 2 lakh rupees. He has a home loan of 50 lakh rupees. He's been investing for the last 9 years in mutual funds. He has 4 mutual fund schemes. He says he started at 23 with just 500 rupees. And what a great example that is for everyone. You don't need too much money to start. He started at 23 with just 500 rupees. There are many of you 23-year-olds out there who can certainly save 500 rupees a month. So start now. That's very inspirational, Sanjay, that you started so long back. He's also continued to increase his SIPs over a period of time as per his advisor and his own research. He has some clear goals. He says he wants 1 crore rupees in the next 15 years for his child's education. His child is now 4 years old. And 2 crores in the next 25 years for retirement at the age of 60. That is a figure you really need to increase, because 2 crore at 60, though you say you've adjusted it for inflation, is still a little less, because you're going to have another 20-25 years to live after that. So you may want to increase that a bit. The schemes that he has, there are 5 schemes that he has: Reliance Value Fund, DSP BlackRock Top 100, Birla Sun Life Frontline Equity, SBI Blue Chip Fund Growth, and Parag Parikh Long Term Equity Fund. He's also doing a 10,000 rupee per month recurring deposit, and he has an FD of 3 lakh rupees. 2 lakh he has kept aside as an emergency fund. 1 crore rupees term insurance cover, 5 lakh family health insurance plus standalone, 5 lakh critical illness plus 20 lakh cancer / heart policy. And he has a total of 10 lakh rupees of cover from LIC, from Jeevan Anand and Jeevan Tarang, which he took in 2009. Wants to know if he's on the right track. He's certainly, Surya, done a lot of things right. And he seems like very conscious about the fact that he wants to build wealth and protect himself as well.
For long term, for sure. I think he's done commendable, as you just rightly mentioned, Vivek, that starting with 500 rupees when he was 23, which is 10 years back, when the awareness was also not so much. That's really commendable. But coming to your need, Sanjay, which you have mentioned, you're currently saving around 48,000 rupees per month, which I think which is a good amount of money which you're doing. The schemes which you carry in the portfolio are too large cap biased. You have 3 schemes which are typically large cap schemes. So you need to kind of move out from large cap. It's good to have 1 large cap fund. And within the large cap space, you actually don't need too many of schemes, because there is not too much which a fund house can do beyond a point in the large cap category. So it's good to go out from there and do a multi cap, do a mid cap. So just diversify your portfolio over here. And as far as the achieving of your goals are concerned, you have mentioned that inflation are adjusted. If that's the case, you will be able to achieve this. However, it's always good to increase your savings every year based on what your incremental incomes are. And as also Vivek just mentioned, that the retirement goal which you have provided for looks a little bit under provided for. So it's good that you will save regularly every year. If you can enhance your savings, I think you will be able to cover that reasonably well. Insurances are well protected, but do review your term insurances as well as medical insurances every couple to 2 to 3 years, because especially your goal changes, your need changes, and in India, the medical inflation is actually the highest in the world. Typically, it's around 25% inflation on the health side. So you have to just keep an eye on that. And every few years, take a review. You already have bumped up by having a cancer policy and you have a critical illness, which is great. But just do review about the same. You have taken an RD within the 48,000 of your monthly saving. I don't see a reason why you want to have that, because you have already protected your contingency emergency by having a FD. So I really don't see a reason why you need to have a recurring deposit happening for a reasonable big sum of money. That's 20% of your monthly saving. So maybe you can do that into a balance fund if you want to keep your portfolio a little more in a safe zone. But otherwise, increase your risk level, because the goals which you have actually are very long term. And I think then you should be able to achieve all the needs which you carry.